Hello friends, welcome back. My name is Balakrishna and you are watching Bala online. Recently India has revoked Article 370 from Jammu and Kashmir. So this talk was going on everywhere. One of my friends and colleagues, other people are asking, what is this Article 370? They know little bit and half of the knowledge and nobody knows what is exactly Article 370 and when it was started and why it has been revoked. So let's start discussing on this Article 370. I will try to explain you in a simple language what is Article 370 and what happens when Article 370 is revoked. Okay, to save the territory of Jammu and Kashmir, the Raja of Jammu and Kashmir has signed a treaty with Jawaharlal Nehru of India on 26th October 1947 and surrendered three major responsibilities to India. That means Jammu and Kashmir has not got any right on these three items. Henceforth, India government will take care. That is number one, defense, number two, external affairs, number three, communications. That means all these three items will be dealt by India. India will have power to decide and action on these three points. Apart from these three points, Jammu and Kashmir will continue to act and continue to take the rights. 370 has been incorporated, created and incorporated within the Constitution of India. That means India is now responsible for the defense, communications and external affairs of Jammu and Kashmir. Let's now discuss what are the rules of this Article 370 and how this impacts Jammu and Kashmir peoples and outside Jammu and Kashmir people like Indians and other states as well. Okay. Basically, when India got free, that is on 15th August 1947, at the same time even the Jammu and Kashmir has got free. But the Raja Hari Singh wanted to keep Jammu and Kashmir free forever, but it could not happen due to various reasons. Hence, he was forced to take help from India. Arrived well on 20th October 1947 when Kashmir Sena along with Pakistani Sena has captured major part of the Kashmir, many areas of the Kashmir. Hence, Raja Hari Singh was forced to take this kind of decisions. It was a very important decision for that time. So, this article was implemented on 17 November 1952 which was now revoked. But with this article, there are also some tricky part which we need to understand and which means that, you know, what Jammu and Kashmir has left out with the rights. Example, so if any rules or any law has to be changed in Jammu and Kashmir, Indian government has to take permission from the state government, nothing but Jammu and Kashmir government, before applying the rules and new rules and regulations. Apart from three items which is won by Indian government, that is defense, communications and external affairs. Article 370, the major rights relies with Jammu and Kashmir. This also means that Jammu and Kashmir has their own constitution and it does not run only with the Indian constitution. Do you know Jammu and Kashmir has two flags, that is one their own Jammu and Kashmir national flags and one Indian flag as well. Point. As per Article 370, if anyone want to buy a property in Jammu and Kashmir, that should be only from Jammu and Kashmir residents, nothing but if I am from India or if I am from XYZ country, I cannot buy property in Jammu and Kashmir. So only a resident or citizenship citizen of Jammu and Kashmir can only buy the property in Jammu and Kashmir. So this means they have sustained their right on their itself. Now let's talk about this citizenship. What citizenship will Jammu and Kashmir people will have? Is that Indian or Jammu and Kashmir JK? Hence, Jammu and Kashmir people will have two citizenship. They were having two citizenship, that is Jammu and Kashmir as well as the Indian citizen. It's called dual citizenship. Now let's see what Article 370 talks about the marital status. Kashmiri girl marries an Indian boy, she automatically loses the Kashmiri citizenship. On the other hand, if a Kashmiri girl marries a Pakistani boy, she does not lose citizenship of Jammu and Kashmir. It means that it does not affect her citizenship at all, even if she marries Pakistani. So however, in the other hand, if you see, if Kashmiri girl marries Indian, she loses Kashmiri citizenship. And if she marries a Pakistani girl, she does not lose any citizenship. So it's a little bit tricky. I don't know. Please comment and let me know what you think about it. The interesting part of this Article 370 comes now. If any Pakistani boy marries a Kashmiri girl, he automatically gets Indian citizenship along with Pakistani. That means even he will get dual citizenship, that is Indian as well as Pakistani. Very interesting. So what do you think about this? please comment and let me know below. Procedure, if Indian or any country goes and settles in different countries, so they automatically loses the citizenship of the current country. Example, I'm an Indian, and if I'm going and settling in Canada, maybe for a longer time, 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, and I'm getting citizenship of that Canada, so automatically I lose citizenship of India. So that means I cannot vote in India. But in this case, if a Kashmiri boy or Kashmiri resident goes to Pakistan and settles there, okay, and maybe after 5, 10, 15 years, he returns back to Kashmir, so automatically he becomes Indian. That means he will get the citizenship of India. So that was mentioned in Article 370. I just came across one more point which I'm not able to understand. I don't know if you are able to understand. Let me know in comment and what you think about it. So in under Article 370, if any Kashmiri residents or Kashmiri citizen degrades any Indian symbol, it does not come under criminal category. However, in India, if anybody discriminates or degrades Indian symbols, that comes under criminal, and you may be you may be coming under a criminal proceedings, but it does not affect in Jammu and Kashmir. So in Article 370, in case if in India if any emergency is implemented, emergency in any case, it does not apply or it does not affect the Jammu and Kashmir. So it remains as separate, like, you know, it doesn't affect the Jammu and Kashmir. It will affect only in India. For this video, I just thought to share about A370 to all of the who are not aware of completely. And I have gathered all this information from the videos or the YouTube videos and the newsletters, newspapers and TV. So I'm just collating and sharing. So this is not my personal opinion. This is from the public and public media domain. So that means now Article 370 has been revoked, which means all this whatever I have discussed now, put across with you, will be revoked and does not applicable with immediate effect. So that means anybody can buy property in Kashmir, and even they can buy property in India, anywhere. So anybody is free to buy property in Kashmir as well. They can reinvest, they can invest in Kashmir. It's not that, you know, like earlier days, we cannot invest, nobody, no foreign people or no other country people can invest in Kashmir. So now we can also invest in Kashmir, my dear friends. This one way it is good thing. And our government has taken this decision now, finally. So I don't want to comment anything on this. It's a government decision, Indian decision. I truly support them. And it has been done for the welfare of the people. I truly support them. So Jai Hind, and let me know what you think about this video. And in case if you require this video in Hindi, let me know. I will try to make that as well. So if you like this video, kindly like this. And if you feel this has to be shared somewhere, you can share with your friends. And in case if you are new to this channel, do subscribe and press the bell notification so that you know you will get any new videos immediately. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.